What up, nerds? It's me, back in my shop again for another Got Wood Wednesdays. Today, it's not technically wood, but we are going to be turning a pen out of my new, some of my new acrylic pieces that I just got in. I'm really excited. This is the first pen I wanted to do since I got all my pieces, and that's what we're going to be doing today. So, without further ado, let's get it. Let's switch over to my new camera position. Okay. Get it all chucked in there. All right. Put that there. Turn the fan on because it is hot. Come up. There. I learned that if you grab the table from the bottom, much easier to maneuver. Okay, now I need my clamps. These blue grip ones are a bitch to fucking open up, but they work perfect for this table size. I mean, they clamp perfectly to the table, and they're not in the way. So. Googles. Google. All right. Center. Damn it. I'm pretty bad off center, but I can fix it. Ugh. I don't know. This is the dangerous part. I think I broke through. Yep, I broke through. Give it the old test. Yep. I don't have to do my extra step of drilling it with the cordless. Oh, that's interesting. I've said it before, it's like if you're off center, as long as it's not too horrible, you can correct that in the lathing process. As long as you have some material, because I think I'm going to be okay. That's better. I guess the reason I have problems is because I have a tendency to line it up this way, but I don't always check the other way. Break it. It definitely went through. But it didn't sound nice going through, so. We'll see. Oh, it went through fine. That one's more centered. Still a little off. Let's see. Quick little test. Yep. Good. So I don't have to do the extra step process of boring it out to get a to get my metal pieces to go all the way through. Yay! I'm getting better at this. Alright. So we needed this. That. Alright. Come on, you heavy beast. How's everybody doing today? Alright. Since I'm doing a slimline pin again, I know the measurements I'm gonna need on the lathe, and so when I I cut myself. I don't know if you can see it. There's a small chip right there. And it looks so red, I thought I actually cut myself. And I mean, I have a little stain here, but that's not a cut and it's not bleeding. So. Interesting. So I mean, it's gonna look pretty damn good when I get done turning it. Okay. So it's time to glue. Need one more thing. Be right back. Bit of sandpaper. Just like I said before, some experts say to rough it up. Gives you a better adhesion. I don't know if they're full of it because I haven't had one of these. Haven't been doing long enough to seen a pin fail. So. That one's pretty roughed up enough. Reminds me back when I was in the army and having to polish all my brass belts and buckles and shit. That reminds me. It's like, these kids going into basic training these days, what the fuck do y'all do all day? I'm curious. I'm generally curious because it seems like now y'all have 100% more free time than I did. I went in 2001 and the majority of my day was spent ironing uniforms and polishing boots. The current military today doesn't have to polish their boots. And doesn't have to iron their uniforms. So what the fuck do y'all do all day? I'm just curious. If anyone has an answer for me, please tell me. I'm not saying that y'all's job isn't any harder than mine was. I'm just saying I'm confused about what y'all, how y'all's downtime is managed. So. But that is what it is. Like I still got mad respect for all my service brothers and sisters. Even the special ones out in the Marines. You know. Just fucking me up. And here's another thing for the civilians. If you hear a person ragging on the Marines to a Marine's face, I wouldn't get offended for the Marine because that's what we do. We talk shit about every branch all the time. It's kind of like a thing to do, you know. It's one of those things is that. I see it as a sign of respect. It's like if I have enough respect to you where I'm going to talk shit about you, tell jokes about you, but I'm going to tell them to you, to your face, then that's a sign of respect for me. But, you know, I was like, I know what they've been through. They know what I've been through. So. I've been in some bars where I've made some Marine jokes to a Marine or a Navy guy, and someone started to yell at me on their behalf while he's laughing. So, thanks for looking out, I guess. But back to the gluing. Now that I have this cut mat, won't get my table so sticky. Alright. Gonna be quick now that stuff's on my glove. No, it was not what I wanted to have happen. Okay. Ah. That's done. It's flat on that side. I cut this too short. Damn. I might have. Fuck. Womp womp. I don't know if it's gonna be that big a deal. Well, I screwed the pooch on that one. I thought I had. You know what this is? It's crap. Alright, well, I'm just gonna let it dry. I'm gonna go forward anyway. So. It's a nice day today. I'm not sweating my ass off like I usually am. Just bummed. But I'm gonna start to do this YouTube thing. I'm gonna film my mistakes and my triumphs. So I'm not scared of messing up on camera. So, what to talk about today? Well, I'm not the biggest fan of the post office right now because I've had two packages in the same week fail to be delivered. And so far, I haven't received a refund. And one of them was my bandsaw that I was excited to get and finally get to do some bigger projects, but somehow it got damaged in the process. Now, it was shipped by the post office and not Amazon, not FedEx or UPS. So I have a tendency, I'm pretty sure I know what happened. What had happened was the mailman was late. It was late in the day. My package was heavy. And he didn't want to carry it. He or she didn't want to carry it to my door like they're supposed to. So they marked it undeliverable and sent it back. Now they've done this a couple times before. Anytime I get a heavy package sent through the mail, they'll say, oh, we couldn't deliver it to your door, even though I'm on the first floor. My door is the easiest to get to in the apartment complex. They try to send me a message, oh, we couldn't deliver it to you. Your package was undeliverable. You'll have to come to the post office to pick it up. It's like, well, not having a car, that's not an option. So, but thanks to Amazon, I was able to get part of that refund back. And I don't know what's going to happen with the other one. There was another order of pen blanks and pen kit accessories I was also excited about. And apparently, it wasn't the post office's fault. I don't think so. It was more their fault. Like, they say that they didn't put my address or my unit apartment number in my shipping label. But when I look at my order and status of it, it clearly shows my apartment number on the order. So I don't know who fucked up there, but I tried calling them today and they didn't answer. So just everyday regular struggles for me, you know. Alright, I'm gonna run, let this dry. I'm gonna go grab another ball of water, and I'll be right like that. Ta-da! And I'm back. Turn the fan back on, because it's getting hot again. Come on. I'm not a fan. The check key. Okay, that's time to barrel trim these mofos. I got super glue on my finger. Some reason things are not wanting to. Heat gun. Still tacky. I don't know why. It usually hardens a lot faster than that. I don't have the activator. Maybe that's what I need to get next. But we gonna roll with it. Yes, it's very squeaky, I know. Unfortunately, I don't think... Scrap this piece, get another piece, be right back. Surprise, I'm back. Quickly cut a new piece, which is why it's always important to buy a spare pack of just backup tubes. So that is going to fit. Now I gotta glue it up, switch this out, and be careful because it's probably going to be hot. That's one way you can get rid of it without touching or without burning yourself. Alright. Thank you. Come on. I don't believe it. That just went in all the way a second ago. Why the hell is it not going in there? I don't know. I'm very confused. I'm very pissed off right now. This shit is not behaving. Let me get a hammer. This is a fail too. Man, why is it not want me to do this? Alright, last time, and I'm gonna skip all the bullshit. I'm too frustrated. I'm gonna stop for today, come back tomorrow, try to do this again. Alright, guys, as always, stay nerdy. Peace. Okay. It took a couple days to calm down, figure out a plan on how I could fix this shit here. Well, I beat the hell out of it. I bent it up, but I still think it's salvageable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just try to sand this. Hopefully I don't fuck up my sander. But we're just going to see how that works. Oh, I hope this works. Look at that. Now, see, see inside there, the metal tube is not going to go all the way through, so that could be an issue during the fitting, the final assembly phase, but I still think that it'll be okay. They're good. Patterning is, it's a little off, but it's two different pieces. I'm lucky I got close enough. I think I know this one's way off. And this one's more center. But I think I can fix that. This is just going to make, I'm going to make this the top piece so it can be more, this is going to be where the cap sits because that's going to be where I need to be the smallest, diameter. And then this that has more room, that's going to be my, the middle section toward the spacer. And then this is pretty much dead even, so this is going to be the spacer. I'll come to that decision when I get closer. But right now I've got an order that is on his way that I have to pick up. So, oh shit. Don't tell me. Okay, where's the cap? I left the lid off of my CA glue. Can't find the cap. Let's see. Always cap your shit. Freaked out. The simple fix. Still, this one is too small, so I have to figure out what I can do with it. But alright, when I got time, I'll come back and finish this. Probably be tomorrow. So, peace. Round three. Kick this pin's ass, because it's been kicking mine, but it's time for a comeback. So, yes, I'm still working on these. All I gotta do is barrel trim them, and then I can get to turning them. See. Grip strength is bitch. Alright, let's put you down there. Alright. Let's get serious. The purpose of barrel trimming, if you didn't catch my other videos earlier, is to trim the acrylic flush with the brass tubing. Also, this is to clean out any glue that may have gotten stuck inside the barrel when you did the gluing up phase. So, always good idea to do this because it can just give you hassles whenever you're doing the lathing process. So, God, these glasses are dirty. Okay. I mean, if you can already see the brass at the top of your piece, you don't need much to barotrim it. You just need to make sure you get all the way through the middle of the tube and take off just the top layer. Happens when you don't tighten your chuck. Okay, almost done. I'm not gonna do it with this one because this one's already sanded flush and that one inside's the one that's depressed. Because if you another reason for the tubing is I believe my belief is that it also performs it's also strengthens, because you just cut a hole in the center of your piece creating a huge weak point, so the brass actually helps and the glue helps it all stay together. Because I've hit a wooden piece that has splinters a lot, and as soon as I hit it with the barrel trimmer it just went tink and came and like cracked halfway down the piece. So if the sides are flush, you don't like I'm not gonna worry about it. So we'll call that good and we'll put this away. I'll bust out the lathe. I definitely want another these metal tables, that way I don't have to keep moving this. This can be anytime you can put a permanent piece in place and never have to move a piece of equipment, it's always ideal. But if you do have to move it, choose one that's less than 50 pounds. Okay, baby. They say lift with your legs, not your back. those off for a second. Next, I'm gonna switch all over to the top view. So, all right. Don't lose your bushings. That's always a good plan. And another good idea when using the lathe a lot, especially for pin turnings. Is that the standard bushings? I just keep on the lathe so I don't lose them. But anytime I'm working with something that's other than the standard 7mm tubing, which is what these bushes are for, I keep them in the same. Where I stored the different types of pin kits, the bigger pin kits, the different sizes, I keep those bushings that are made for that pin kit with those. I keep those bushings with those pin kits. Like, I just got these in yesterday. These are for my 30mm pin. Bolt action pin. I'm gonna put those with those right now so I don't forget. Definitely time for me to lubricate my lathe. I'm just not 100% sure on what exactly I need or what type of lathe oil, machine oil I need. Okay. And you want to tighten these down to where you can't turn these out of position with your hands. So you want to cinch it all up. That's pretty good. And position this. And the good thing about this lathe is that once you cinch it down good, you can pull the handle back and put it in a position where it's out of the way. You can do that for all of these. Just lift up, turn. Alright. I think we're gonna call that good. Got a few more things to set up, gotta get ready for. Then it's time for light speed. See y'all set. my... That was a bitch. Ain't gonna lie. I went ahead and time-lapsed the sanding, the rough sanding. Still busting out the micro mesh pads. And with acrylic, it's always a good idea to wet sand, which is what I did mainly for the rough sanding. And I got my measurements within a thousandth of an inch on where my measurements need to be. Grit. Now this was a bit of a pain in the ass, I'm not gonna lie. This was a lot harder than I was expecting. Maybe because this is the one I wanted to turn the most. Why it gave me the most hassle. You know that thing. Sometimes that's how it works, you know. And the thing also about this is that because it's so white over here, I can't tell if it's doing any good. Like, I can't really see how good a polish it's getting. And then it always has this flaky crap that wants to sit on it. Still there. I don't know if this is gonna work. That looks even worse. I need a rag.
I don't have it.
Yet. This whole process is frustrating me. Okay. I'm seeing hope. That's looking a lot better. I think I know what those are. Yep, those are tool marks. I didn't get all of them out. Damn. All right. Well, looks like I'm gonna have to go. Just some rough wet sand and hopefully get those tool marks out. I don't want to take too much off the end because it's already at the dimension I want, so. Alright, see. Okay. Alright, well, I got most of the tool marks out. I gotta give it some more. Come on. Okay. That tool mark's gone. I'm really only concerned about the tool marks in the red because they are the most visible. See, like the specks right there. Okay. So I'm not gonna mess with that one no more. Look how pretty that is once it's all glossed up. Okay. Enough of that. We'll do the last four layers of micro mesh. So I believe I'm on 3600 grit. Come on. Damn. This won't go away. Maybe the thing is I'm holding the sanding for too long. Last, not least, okay. Let's give these a final caliper measurement. So the tip I want at 30.32 inches. It's 0.33, so a thousandth off. It's okay. The spacer. Ooh. I want a little under, I want a little too much on that one. Cap, end cap, 35.35, perfect, right on the money. And the other spacer is about a thousandth over. So, not horrible, but now let's do the polish, so hopefully it doesn't keep doing that. I got this one-step plastic polish for supposedly just the acrylic pens here. Guaranteed to remove chisel marks, sanding scratches, scuffs, and blemishes.
Let's hope so.
Shake well before using. For best result, first, sand your plastic turning with 400 to 600 grit sandpaper. Well, you did a lot more than that. Apply one step liberally with a clean, lintless, dry cloth or directly onto the plastic turning while it is at rest. Okay.
We will get some paper towels. We'll go from there. I'm here back.
Okay. Ah, we got this. Shavings everywhere. Okay. So this is apply medium pressure until heat buildup and turning surface appears to be clean, dry, and polished. Apply multiple coats as necessary until you achieve the scratch-free polished results. Okay. Well, I think I'm just gonna
sure, I know what to do. Come on, damn it. Expecting it to be green. Interesting. Very interesting. Says it's non-toxic and environment friendly and all that jazz, so just gonna rub it on. Even though it says it's non-toxic and safe, probably don't want to get to some eyes. Okay. Well, looks like I'm gonna need another coat. Okay. I see those two spots. Okay. It is very smooth though. All right, well, I'm gonna let that sit for now. I'm gonna call it a day. I'm probably gonna go jump in the pool because it's hot. Man, this thing has been kicking my butt since day one. But hold on. So, like I said, all I got left is the assembly process. That doesn't take very long. I could do it now, but I don't want to. I want to go soak in the pool and think about my life choices. So, this isn't the end of the video. I will finish the process and catch y'all on the flip side. Alright. I done forgot what round this is because this has been a very difficult job. This thing looks pretty damn good. A few minor defects, which probably no one will know but me. Now it's time for final assembly. Okay. Don't stay. This. Closer.
fan off. Since it is nighttime, it's not incredibly hot right now. I'm not exactly sure why this particular pen was so challenging. I guess it just comes down to the acrylic or the type of how the acrylic may have been made. I'm not exactly sure, but where's my calipers? Want to double check which end is which, although I pretty much know. Okay, that's the tip. Spacers there. There. And then that. Okay. Tip first. Now, when assembling, you don't have to have this particular vise set up, although you can just do it by hand or by regular vise, but this one is just, it's pretty simple. I like it. Man, I'm getting really good at the using the calipers properly ensures that you almost have a seamless finish. There's just, I mean, it's hardly even, I can barely get my fingernail on it. That's how good. That's what proper measurements do for you. Okay. This one. That's why that went in so easy. This was the section that I had, that's missing the whole brass tube. So it has a little bit more room in there, so it's probably not gonna. I'll probably be able to travel on me a bit. One thing I noticed also is before you go and set it up, there's a little cap or plastic sleeve on top of the tip here. It'll come off when you give it a good writing, but you can always just peel this off beforehand. Alright. Okay. That's a bit more. Son of a bitch. I pinched my in my finger. Okay. Good to me. It could come out a little bit further, but I'm not gonna worry about it. So. So, spacer. And then, ooh. I like this. So, like, you can tell. Oh, that's good. So it'll line up when the tip's out with this section here, and then when it's pushed, when it's twisted to close, it'll line up with that section there. That looks dope. Man, I pinched myself pretty good. All right. I'm gonna put the cap over those two areas that I couldn't, those two chisel marks I couldn't work, sand out, so. Okay. Oh, look at that. That turned out pretty damn dope. I'm pretty happy with that. So, there you have it. And I just dropped it. God, I'm clumsy as hell today. So that's it for today's Got Wood Wednesday. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And as always, stay nerdy, my friends.
Peace.